A lot of people like me found things that were intensely personal and really struck a chord in Cheryl's book. And I understand that you leapt into action to option it as soon as you read it. And I wonder if you could tell us what in particular struck a chord with you.
Well, so much. I mean, it's so interesting as people are seeing the film that they all take something different from it. So for me, I suppose, just the idea of this woman being on a journey to find herself, doing it completely alone. I think that was the part I kept thinking about, even when we were shooting it, is that could I do this? Well, yeah, I could probably hike. I could probably do this, but could I do it all alone for 94 days without anyone? And that was what I found really remarkable. We saw Dallas Buyers right before it came out, and we were immediately just awestruck by that film, and we thought, God, could we possibly be able to get him to direct our movie? The way he handles sexuality in that movie, the way that he tackled tough subject matter without making it saccharine or maudlin, I think he was just incredible. And he read the script right away and called us immediately and said, he actually put another movie to the side that he's making right now. He said, I have to make this film right now. I want to start immediately. So we were really fortunate. Well, you know, like Cheryl and I were talking about it last night about, you know, the boxes that people put people in. I think, you know, I had that experience. I certainly learned from that experience. I felt terrible about that experience. But I think it was also a moment where I think people sort of realized I wasn't exactly what they thought I was, maybe. I mean, I guess maybe we like to sort of define people by the ways the media presents them and that sort of thing. And I think if it shows I have a complexity that people didn't know about, I think that's part of human nature. I made a mistake. We all make mistakes. The best you can do is say sorry and learn from it and move on. Well, Jean-Marc wanted me on the day. He purposely made it so that I didn't know. Because Cheryl started her hike and she had never backpacked, ever. he wanted me to have no experience with any of the props. So when you see me putting together the tent, that's me literally putting together a tent. He filmed me for 2 hours. No one was helping me. So when I'm shaking and I'm going, Jesus, I literally could not figure out the fucking tent. And when I kick the stove, it's because I couldn't make the fucking stove work.
There were no fucks in the script. She just...
yeah. So the backpack, I, you know, being an actor for so many years, I was like, they're going to stuff it full of newspaper. It's no big deal. I'm just going to, like, carry it around. And we got there on the day, and I put on the thing, and I said to the prop guy, just put newspaper in it. And Jean-Marc came over, and he said, is there anything in the backpack? And I said, no, I'm not gonna, like, hike across the thing with the heavy backpack. And he's like, actually... He's like, I think it would be better if you had the heavy on your shoulders, and I see the way you walk. And I was like, are you joking me? And he said, no, I think it's better. And then he just, like, walked off. I was like, oh, my God. So I ended up carrying it the whole time. And I've never been as strong as I was after that movie. I had some back problems. Yes. Nick was writing, and we were talking. And then right before we started shooting, I flew up to Portland to hang out with her and spend more time with her. And we got to... Oh, we spent your birthday together.
We spent my birthday together.
Yeah. And she actually had the benefit, too, of her being on set almost every day, other than when she was on speaking engagements. She and her husband were there, so... It actually helped me. It was encouraging. I think in some ways I was a little scared in the beginning, like, oh my God, she's going to be watching me, and then she's going to be judging me, and I don't know if I can do this. But she was actually this incredibly loving, supportive presence. And that sometimes she'd come and it would actually help me get into the scene. And I had the book to read over and over and over again, so... Definitely the hardest movie I've ever done in my entire life, for many different reasons. The physicality was really difficult, but after the physicality was definitely the part I was dreading the most was the emotional part of it. The grief, the divorce, the sex scenes were the hardest thing for me to do, honestly. So hard. I remember writing Cheryl like the night before. I was like, I don't know how much I'm supposed to have sex with two strangers tomorrow. Basically, I'm going to shake their hand and like have sex with them in an alley. I've never had to do anything like that in my entire life. And so Cheryl came to set that day. I was like, thanks for coming today.
I was like, I can't believe you've never done this.
But I had to tell myself, like, look, if she was brave enough to be completely open as an artist and talk about those things, I couldn't just do the parts of it that I was comfortable with. You know, I had to do all the parts of the movie, the parts that made me feel uncomfortable too, because it is about emotional honesty. And so I said to Cheryl, I was like, I cannot believe I have to do this today. And she said, she came up and she goes, I'm so sorry I was such a slut in the 90s.
Thank you. Go ahead.
I think it's a very personal film in a lot of ways. And I think I didn't really discover how personal it was until I was already halfway there. And I would send Cheryl emails and while I was doing things that I mean, there's aspects of it that everybody knows that I've gone through, which are, you know, divorce and struggles with, you know, all kinds of things. But there's other things that people don't know about me. And it became very personal. You know, it's about, for me, a lot of it is about finding yourself one step at a time, completely alone. And I think everyone who's ever made it this far in life, any age in life, realize that there's a day you wake up and you realize, I'm all alone. No one's riding in on a white horse and saving me. And the thing I thought was so extraordinary about the piece of material, about the book itself, and we hoped for the movie, I said to Bruno before we started, I said, if we can pull this off, it might be the first time in history, the first time a woman's in a movie and she ends the movie with no man, no money, no parents, no job, no opportunities, and it's a happy ending.
And not very good shoes, either.
Yes, sir.
I think, you know, it's a great responsibility to have a platform where you bring movies to an audience globally. You know, I think you have to be mindful of what you want to say. I mean, certainly I do popcorn movies. I love those movies, too. I have a great time doing them. And comedy, interestingly enough, has sometimes in my career, it's extraordinary to me how much it affects people. But a film like this is, in a way to me, it's bigger than a movie. Because of, you know, I saw it the other day with my mother, and Laura Dern, she saw it with her parents, and they all our mothers held hands as they watched the movie. It was really beautiful, but the conversation that I had with my mother and Laura's mother afterwards was probably one of the most important conversations of my life. Just about realizing what it means to be a mother or a daughter, knowing that our mothers were seen and understood, it was profound for them. And those aren't conversations that you have, you know, around the Thanksgiving table or at Christmas time because you're busy or the kids are running around, but to take the time to really contemplate who you are as people, with people that you love. I think that's one of my favorite parts of this film is that people are sharing it with people they love. I think that's an important part of the book as well. I mean, that I thought was amazing in books is that we're taught, even as little girls, be afraid. Mm. Be afraid. Don't wear that skirt. You know, don't go out alone. Cross your legs. You know? And I think one of the really great things about the book and the film is that she forgives herself of her sexual experiences, you know, and I feel like so many times we're told as a woman to be ashamed of any experience that you have, and I think it's really a revelation to have a character, a woman in film going, what if I was supposed to sleep with all those guys? What if I learned something about it? what if that's okay? And I think that was extraordinary. Oh, yeah. Wow, I forgot about that movie. Hi.
Do you remember everything?
Yeah, I do. Well, kind of. Really, I've had a few kids. Talking about physical life experience, probably having kids. 3 children was a physical experience, not to be forgotten. yeah, I remember that movie. Yeah, it was a Disney movie where a boy and I walk across the Kalahari Desert. You're right, 3,000 miles. But we didn't. 3,000 miles. And I really carried a very light backpack with newspaper stuff.
Hilarious.